The word on this morning, hallelujah, by the goodness and grace of God, amen. The Lord is bringing us through, hallelujah. I want to thank the Lord today, amen. Thank God for all of you that came through calendar year 2021, and we're in calendar year 2022, amen. Are y'all in the same year? Amen. We in calendar year 2022. Praise God. Amen. But I want you, everybody talk about New Year's resolutions and, the changes that y'all make and so forth. What the Lord put in my spirit, calendar year has changed. Okay. All right. But in the world of the spirit, y'all, it's a continuation. All right. It's a continuation. Amen. So a lot of people say, well, look, no, in the spirit realm, it's a continuation. Yes. Hallelujah, amen. So I don't want you to be discouraged, and I don't want you to be put out. But, God does not change because of the calendar year. Yes. Come on, y'all. See, God says things according to season.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah, amen. His seasons most of the time don't match up our season. Oh, praise God. Amen. And the people was looking, and my word today, because people was looking for the ball to drop down. People was waiting for it. They had the ball in New York, and one city they had the bologna, and another city they had the tomato, and another city they had something else. But they had different stuff, amen, to celebrate. Then drop down. Hallelujah. Amen. We had none of those things, y'all. Oh, praise God. Amen. As a matter of fact, at the world clock of midnight, amen, I don't know whether I was talking to the Lord or what. I was asleep. Come on, y'all. I was asleep. I was asleep. Amen. Because the Lord has settled in my spirit, whatever was going on, amen, and this is the word for you today, hallelujah, amen. We serve a God who does not work according to this time, world's time clock. Amen. God, amen. Listen, if we can, and my word for us for this particular season, we need to understand that what we see is not what we see.
Oh, come on!
Praise God. What you're dealing with is really not what you're dealing with. All that we're seeing and dealing with in this climate and meditating on this much, because there's so much going on, y'all. Amen. As a believer, you've got to be able to look behind the seeing to see the unseen. Amen. Because what you see is controlled by what you don't see. Oh, praise God. Amen. And so there's a lot happening in the world of the spirit, y'all. And that's why you see the stuff that's happening in the natural physical world. The Bible puts it this way, amen, that the whole earth is in travail. Come on, y'all. Amen. They're in travail. And what you're seeing, y'all, is nature travail. And you see the African travail. And you see the whole world in travail. Amen. Stars and galaxies. So everything is in travail, which should let you know, amen, my sermon this morning, amen, I'm going to talk about the upward call, amen, the upward call, and should let you know, amen, the things, amen, is about to change.
Yes.
Hallelujah, amen. Things is about to change, and things is in travail, amen, and I'm somewhat at a question mark to why we as the people of God are not in travail. Amen. The Bible has left us something that should guide us and let us know, amen, that the greatest message that we have as the body of Christ, y'all, amen, it's about Jesus, amen, and the greatest work that we can do, hallelujah, amen, is the work of intercession.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. As you see these things, amen, you have authority and power with the Father. You need to bring to the Father. Not that he don't know about him. Come on, y'all. Amen. But see, it ties you in to the purposes of what he's doing. Amen. Because The Lord does nothing except He first hears from us.
Yes.
Now you need to understand, y'all, things is not out of control. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, come on, y'all. Amen. He gave the earth, y'all, and the things of the earth is given to us, the sons of men. Amen. In the beginning, God put Adam in the garden to rule over stuff. Praise God, amen. By his behavior, he lost control.
Yes.
Come on, y'all, amen. And the world became shipwrecked. And, hallelujah, amen. But the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Hallelujah. He came in to rescue, amen, us from the direction we've gone, amen. And he did practice recovery. Come on, y'all. Amen. And I'm so glad today, hallelujah, he recovered me. Praise God. He recovered me. Amen. And I'm thankful. I'm going to go with this as one to the book of Galatians chapter number 5. Amen. That's where we're going to anchor ourselves in today, because I want to encourage you as we move forward in this calendar year.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. As we move forward in this calendar year, I want to tell you some things, not that you don't know, but rather to remind you of some things about you and your status. Amen. Sometimes you need to be reminded of who you are. Amen. And what you are, and where you come from, and where you're going. Come on, somebody. Amen. And we need to understand, y'all, that there's an upward call. Amen. And that's a calling. Amen. We sing a song. The Lord is calling us to a higher place of praise. Amen. Amen. So as the world moves on one plane, understand, y'all, we move on a different plane. Come on, y'all. We move on different. And it seems like we're going in the same direction, but we're not necessarily going in the same direction. Amen. And so I thank the Lord on this morning. Praise God. Amen. I ask the Lord to just prepare your hearts that we can receive what God has for us. Amen. At this particular juncture in time. Amen. Some of us, as we reflect back, amen, on 2021, some things were not that great. Amen. Some things you would like to forget, don't want to remember. But understand, you will always have memory. What has happened has happened. Amen. Praise God. And like Mama used to say, don't start crying over the spilled milk. Just get a broom, get a mop or whatever, and clean it up. Amen. Because you can't eat spilled milk. The most you can do is clean it up. Amen. And so in our lives, y'all, if you've got spilled milk, the most you can do is clean it up. Amen. You can no longer utilize it as milk. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. See, our problem today, a lot of times, we're trying to go back into something we can't go back into. But God is calling us to move forward. Hallelujah. God is calling us to move forward. Amen. And there's an upward call. There's a difference between an upward call and an outward call. Hallelujah. Amen. An upward call has to do with a call from the Spirit. Amen. That God is calling us to a place in Him. Amen. You might not necessarily observe it in the natural, my God, but you can move there in the Spirit. Praise God. Amen. And please understand that we are a spiritual people. Hallelujah. Amen. We're spiritual people. We're generated by the Spirit of God. One of the things that we deal with, y'all, is when we allow our spirit nature to be contaminated with our human nature. Amen. And we take on the mindset of humanistic thinking, amen, instead of spirit thinking. Come on, y'all. See, there's two ways of looking at where you are, where you're going, and what's happening. Amen. You can look at it from the plane of the natural, but you can also look at it from the plane of the Spirit. I prefer to look at it from the plane of the Spirit, because as I begin to deal with it on the natural, y'all, I can become very pessimistic, amen, about what I see. Hallelujah. Amen. And not desiring to go on. Hallelujah. Not only in the natural world, but also in the church world and everything that's going on. The news stories that you hear constantly bombarding us with negativity, y'all. Oh, praise God. Amen. If you look at it for its face value, you could become depressed. But you got to know that since God brought you out, you know he ain't called you for depression. Come on, y'all. And so when you start having those kind of feelings, you got to tell yourself, listen, this isn't God. Right. Amen. And you got to learn how to shake it off.
Yes.
Amen. You got to learn how to shake it off. Hopefully, you'll be blessed in this year. Amen. And part of the blessing, Ellen, though, as you read it in Sunday school, amen, from Romans chapter 12, you got to renew your mind.
Yes.
Amen. You got to renew your mind. Amen. You can't think crazy thinking.
All right,
crazy thinking would produce crazy lifestyle.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Amen. So the Bible tells us we need to renew our mind. Understand, to renew, y'all, is the constant process. You can't say, I've been renewed, and then stop there. And that's a problem in the body of Christ. People say, I'm saved now, I'm okay. Oh, no. Amen. It's a journey.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Every day you got to work on you.
Yes.
Amen. Because every day God will unfold a little bit more of you that he don't like. Because it don't line up with him. Amen. And so it's a continuous process.
Yes.
Hallelujah, amen. And in the church world, we've looked at it as if though it's an act, amen. But listen, y'all, serving God is not an act. Amen. It's a process. Hallelujah. Go with the word, amen. And I pray that I'm gonna bless your souls on today as you imbibe in the word of God, amen. About your upward calling, amen. Verse number one, Paul said. So Christ, and I'm reading from the New Living Translation, so Christ has truly set us free.
Woo! Yes.
It is no joke. It's really not. Christ has truly set us free.
Yes.
Amen. Now make sure. Make sure that you stay free.
Yes.
And what the problem is, y'all, since Christ has set us free, y'all, we don't stay free. Come on, y'all. We don't stay free. And he said, and don't get tied up again in slavery to the law. Amen. And I'm going to speak of the law as things that you came out of. Amen. Don't get tied back up into those things. Hallelujah. And understand the law for you is different than the law for me. Come on, y'all. Amen. There are some things that I came out of that I have to guard myself from getting tangled back in.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Amen. And you got to be careful of that because, understand, y'all, a lot of times you move, but people and situations don't.
Yes.
And so they were always want to relate to you where they knew you at.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Amen. Although you're no longer there, they're still, I see it all the time, they're still trying to deliver mail to your own address.
Oh, yes.
Come on, y'all. Amen. And you've got to learn, amen, to ride on and say, return to sin. You can't receive that stuff. Hallelujah. Amen. At the point of maybe losing a friend. Amen. Because the upward calling is greater, y'all. Amen. Some of the relationships that we're involved with.
Amen.
And so you got to make a decision that I'm going to live for God in spite, amen, of the relationships that I'm in.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
That will untie you. Hallelujah. That will untie you. Amen. That's why Paul said that you're truly free. Amen. You're truly free. Amen. And so don't get tied up into some slavery stuff. I guard against that, y'all. As your pastor, and I listen to other ministries, and you listen to them. Amen. That people try to tie us back into stuff that we came out of.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. Y'all notice we didn't have no New Year Watch me not. I need to watch the new year in and the old go out. I need to watch every day.
Amen.
Come on, y'all. Amen. And God has shown me watch. Amen. And pray that I don't enter into temptation. Now that's what the Bible told me. And so, amen. And so, please don't belittle me because I'm not into the traditions of the church culture. Of the church culture. There's the world church culture, and then there's the church culture. Church has culture, y'all. And I look at it, and I see on Facebook, on YouTube, I see the church culture. Amen. And so God has set me free from a lot of church culture.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Amen. That's why a lot of people, amen, would not feel comfortable here because we don't have church culture. Amen. Praise God. We don't have church culture. Amen. We're about Jesus now.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen. We're about promoting Jesus now. Mm-hmm. And you're not about promoting Jesus now. Amen. Amen. You're going to feel out of place here. Amen.
Yeah.
Because we love Jesus now.
I
know that's your favorite artist, that's your favorite preacher, so forth. That's why I let them do what God called them to do. Amen. I learned to lead them along.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Because I'm here to promote Jesus then. Amen. I want Jesus then, and I believe what the problem is, y'all, within our own selves, y'all, is that we all promote Jesus then.
Mm-hmm.
It's Jesus then. Amen. Jesus, Peter, Paul, Philip. Come on, y'all. Jesus. That Jesus. That Mary. Come on, Salome. Jesus then. Amen. So who you preaching about? I'm going to talk about Jesus then. Hallelujah. I'm going to talk about Jesus. And I ain't got nothing wrong, and I'm not against the Old Testament prophets and all that. I'm not against them. Understand? I'm not against them. Amen. But see, the Bible teaches me, amen, when you come into light, walk in the light. Amen. And the Bible said all things were written for our what? For our learning. Amen. So some things you learn from, but there are other things that you live by. Come on, y'all. When you talk about Jesus, that's the stuff you live by.
Yes.
Mm. Let me get on down the road here, y'all. Because I moved the stop sign up on this morning. Amen. Because I want to have communion. Amen. Hallelujah. At the stop sign. Hallelujah. And I don't want to hold y'all beyond the normal stop sign. Oh, praise God. So I got to back up a little bit, amen, so that we can have communion, amen, because communion would tie into what we're saying today, hallelujah, amen, about this we're called, hallelujah, because what communion does, y'all, communion connects us in the realm of the spirit.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It connects us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It's a powerful symbolism, amen, of where we are today.
Yes.
Amen. Listen, Paul said, verse 2, he said, I tell you this, if you are counting on circumcision to make you right with God, then Christ would be of no benefit for you. Now, see, his problem he dealt with there was the problem of circumcision. Come on, y'all. The problem we're dealing with, y'all, is church life. Come on, y'all. It's church life. Because since some of y'all, amen, it's tied to church life. Come on, y'all. Y'all tied to church life.
Well.
Y'all tied to church life. You mean y'all ain't having communion every Sunday? No. You mean y'all gonna go to church 5 days a week? No. What's wrong with y'all? Ain't you a Christian? Yeah. Ain't you doing this, that? No. And so I'm dealing today, y'all. My struggle today, amen, is dealing with God's life versus church life. Praise. I'm not getting tied up into church life. Praise God. Amen. Verse 3, he said, I'll say it again. He said, if you are trying to find favor with God, by being circumcised, you must obey every regulation in the whole law of Moses. People think that if you don't go to church, you ain't saved. Church life. They think that church maintains your salvation.
Well,
amen. You're going to find out the other flip. There's another side that's going, y'all. Amen. But it does not maintain that. That's not it, y'all. Amen. And people will say that you're not saved because when? Well, I miss you at Sunday service. And they say it in a way, y'all. I'm serious. They say it in a way, amen, that they condemn you.
Come on,
y'all. See, and that's what the Bible said. The Bible said when you're set free, you're free indeed. Amen. Now, it goes, listen, it goes deeper than the surface stuff. Come on, y'all. Amen. Because in actuality, amen, if you're not worshiping me, you got to tell me, amen, there is something going on. Come on, y'all. There is something going on. Now, maybe you're not telling me, but there is something going on.
Amen.
Come on, y'all. Amen. If I come home every day, amen, and I come home every day since Davis ain't home on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday. Come on, y'all. And she's free, but something going on. Amen. Please don't chastise me, amen, because I asked her, honey, where have you been? Amen. To go where she wants to. But every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, she is. She's not there. Amen. So she's showing a pattern. Hallelujah. Amen. And because I love her, y'all, then I want to help her to make sure she did not get sidetracked. Come on, y'all. Amen. And so I watch stuff like that. Oh, praise God. See, there's freedom. Amen. But you got to be careful of how freedom is being utilized.
Yes, yes, sir.
All right, Pastor.
Praise God. Amen. And so what Paul said in verse 4, he said, if you're trying to make yourself right with God by keeping the law, you have been cut off from Christ. You have fallen away from God's grace. And that's the thing, y'all. Please, understand. Don't use situations and things to say, justify your life. You're not justified. Well, I said, you're not justified. I had to go, you're not justified. Those things don't justify you. And the people of God use the stuff to try to justify and say, well, I'm still saved. Come on, don't whoop at me. When you start whooping at me, you're talking about you. You got some issues that you got to clear up in your life. Praise God. You need to clear them up because if there was nothing there, you wouldn't say nothing. Oh, praise God. Listen to what he said, verse 5. But we who live by the Spirit eagerly wait to receive by faith the righteousness that God has promised us. Amen. When you live by the Spirit, y'all, I don't need to be justified by the flesh. Hallelujah. Because see, I'm justified when I live by the Spirit, then I'm justified by the Spirit. And I will give account because I'm spiritually related to it. Come on, y'all. Amen. Not because of my physical connection to you. Amen. But because of my spirit connection to you. And this is an error where the people of God has lost sight, amen, of who they are and where they are. Because everything is about the physical and natural. And not understanding, that's not it. It's about the spirit.
Amen. Yes,
yes, yes.
My God, my God, my God.
Somebody needs to put a band on here. Oh, praise God. Verse number 6, he said, for when we place our faith in Jesus Christ, there's no benefit in being circumcised or being uncircumcised.
Yes.
What is important is faith expressing itself in love. Amen. Faith expressing itself in love. Amen. That's what's important. Amen. If you got your faith, then that faith needs to be expressing in love. Amen. I look for the love relationship. Hallelujah. Amen. You want to tell me about your external relationships. I don't care about that. I want to know. Amen. Do you still love them? still love me tomorrow? Come on, God. Will you love me tomorrow? I know we had our little thing today, but will you love me tomorrow? See, because see, when you have faith in God, and then regardless of what happened today, you'll love me tomorrow. Because that's where the Lord first put in my spirit was verse 9. And for the life of me, I can't get it. I want to tell you, I ain't get it. Illinois, I ain't understand what God was saying. I really, I didn't get it. I say, oh God, okay God, that's what you say, okay. I ain't get it. I was dumber. Amen. Until I started to meditate on scripture, and then God brought me to this scripture here. Amen. And then it became revealed. You understand? I started to understand what God was saying. Let's look at verse 8. He said, it's certainly not, isn't God. Y'all are doing good, but who? And then verse 8, he said, it certainly isn't God, for he is the one who called you to freedom.
Yes, sir.
So you find yourself buying up again. God didn't retire you.
Oh,
God didn't put you out. God didn't distract you. How you got to be where you are? It wasn't God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Because God was the one who gave you freedom in the first place. So why are you tied up again? God don't free you to retie you. It's not from God. It's not from God. And then people want to start instruct others.
Oh, come on.
When they get retired, they want to instruct us. Well, you know, they do this and they say this and all of this. And they start to instruct others, amen, of what's wrong, hallelujah, amen, in the church.
Jesus.
Come on, y'all. They got retired. Come on, y'all. It's like Jesus said, whoever said, somebody said, when they wanted him to divide his heritage with his brother. And the Lord said, who made me a ruler and judge over you?
Yes.
Oh, praise God. See, y'all, our job is to preach Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm not here to preach Baptist. I'm not here to preach Pentecostal. I'm not here to preach Presbyterian. I'm not here to preach a Church of God in Christ. I'm not here to preach that.
Yes,
I'm here to preach Jesus Christ,
yes,
and him crucified.
Yes. Amen.
Oh, praise God. Amen. Yes. You are wherever you are.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Yes. Amen. If y'all line up the cross at the cross, I'm going to cut you up if you're not at the cross.
Oh, come on now.
I don't care what kind of label you put on.
Yes, sir.
Amen. The most important place you need to be at the cross. Come on, listen to what he said. He said, this false teaching is a little yeast.
Come on, you better watch.
It's a little yeast that spreads throughout the whole batch of dough. And so when God gave me that scripture about a little leaven of his own, I said, Lord, what can that have to do with anything? I'm serious. I didn't get it. I can understand. God, what are you talking about? Amen. Until I start to look at the scripture in the spirit, start to enlighten me. Amen. Of the context of what God was doing, since the Lord has set us free. Praise God. Amen. There's a little stuff. Come on, y'all. It's not a big, it's a little thing that you heard that's contaminating your life. It's a little thing. It's a little mistruth. Amen. It's a little, it's not big, it's a little that has messed our minds up. Little. Not big, little. And it's insignificant. You would never notice it was there. But it has brought in a mess. Amen. And contaminated her from fallen truth. It don't take much to get you out of the path. It just takes a little. And that scripture did, it start to have meaning to that a little leaven leavens a whole lump.
Yes.
Amen. And so it's a little thing.
Yes.
Amen. It's not that you're going out there and doing some big sin.
That's, right.
That's not the problem.
That's not
it's a little thing. Amen. It's a little thing. It's so little and it's insignificant and most people will not recognize.
Oh, come on.
But it has messed your life up. Just a little. Just a little. Praise God. Just a little. Verse 10, he said, I'm trusting the Lord to keep you from believing false teachers. For God would judge that person, whoever he is, who has been confusing you.
Yes, he will.
God gonna deal with the person.
My God.
That's gonna confuse in you. See, because God is not the author of confusion. Y'all need to understand that. And whatever confusion is, understand God is not there.
Yes.
He is not the author of confusion. And, but somebody gave you a little teaching. That's brought in this confusion in their life.
My God. My God.
Oh, praise God. Just a little.
My God.
Just a little. Y'all, it doesn't take much to contaminate food. Then you can get violently sick.
Oh, yeah.
God said, I'll take care
of
him. That's what God said, I'll take care of him. Whoever did it, God said, I'll take care. That's why I don't have to address all these other things. You know, see, when you preach Christ, Christ alone in here.
Oh, yes. Come on.
Deal with it. Come on. All you got to do is preach Christ. We don't have to preach stuff.
Come on.
When we preach the gospel, amen, the gospel is powerful enough to deal with the stuff.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. That's why you won't hear me say nothing about y'all coming to leave. Oh, come on, y'all. Amen. I say nothing about y'all giving or not giving.
Come on.
I say nothing about your attendance or lack of attendance. Come on, y'all. I'm going to preach you the truth because if the truth gets you,
yes.
Amen, it will change you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you're listening and receiving the truth, then we'll look, amen, for the outward signs of love in your life. But if you're not, if you're not receiving the truth, then you will continue in the way that you're going. I love the scripture, what Jesus said. He said he came to his own, and his own received them. So how many people are not receiving the truth? It's not as we give, but they're not receiving. Hallelujah. Amen. And they've allowed the enemy of the cross to give them a little letter that has knocked them off the path of righteousness. God, hallelujah. Verse 11, he said, dear brothers and sisters, if I was still preaching that you must be circumcised, as some say I do, why am I still being persecuted? If I were no longer preaching salvation through the cross of Christ, no one would be offended. Why are they offended? They're offended because of the truth.
Yes.
Yeah, the truth, amen, offends people.
Yes.
Because what the truth does, it shows them up.
Yes.
That they're not walking in truth.
Yes.
sets you free.
Yes.
Not by your opinion.
No,
not by your perception.
No,
those things don't. It's not true. They don't set you free.
They don't set you free.
Truth sets you free.
Yes, sir.
Jesus, hallelujah. Verse 12, he said, I just wish that those, Paul said, who those troublemakers who want to mutilate you by circumcision would mutilate themselves. Paul said, I hope they would turn on themselves. Amen. Verse 13, for you have been called, the upper call, you have been called to live in freedom. My brothers and sisters, but don't use your freedom to satisfy your sinful nature. Instead, use your freedom to serve one another in love. If you're free, then your freedom should be used to serve one another in love. Not in hate, not in malice, but to serve one another. See, the outward signs that you're free is in your service. In this world, the world is more godly than the people of God. When those tornadoes hit Kentucky, was it Kentucky? The next day, they didn't care whether it was Baptist or Methodist. Amen. But everybody was out there to help everybody. Come on, y'all. Out there to help everybody. Serving in the, not can't walk. Are you Baptist? Well, I can't help you. Are you black? I can't help you.
Jesus.
Oh, you go at church and you know, we got to thank you after that back in the church trying to go. No way I'm going to help you. Come on, y'all. After that hurricane and tornado, amen. After that severe weather, y'all, people came together to help one another. There's a black guy that drove all the way from, I'm trying to think, Louisiana someplace. He came with his truck filled with food, amen, and set up a grill and so forth in the middle of town, amen, to serve whoever. And his words were, you know, people got to eat. I got truck full with food, and he just set up there to feed whoever. See, that's love. That's love. See, I hopefully we got the right understanding of love. Love has nothing to do with denomination.
No, sir.
Love has nothing to do with church affiliation.
No, sir.
Come on, y'all. Love, amen, connects upwardly. Hallelujah. It connects upwardly. Hallelujah. It connects upwardly. Amen. And then verse 14, he said, for the whole law can be summed up in this one command. Love your neighbor as yourself. So if you want to talk about, you know, going to church so far, then you need to love me. Love me like you. How you doing today? Well, today I ain't doing too good. Well, you need to understand that today I'm not doing good.
That's right.
Oh, praise God. Amen. In love one another, then you will treat me like you treat you.
Yes.
I think some people treat themselves bad.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Come on, they treat themselves bad. Hallelujah. Amen. You need to learn how to love you. And I know y'all love you because y'all love me. All right, that's what I'm saying. Come on. First, 15 says, but if you are always, listen, right, but if you are always biting and devouring one another, watch out, beware of destroying one another.
Right.
So, y'all, the problem, y'all, within the church of Jesus Christ moving forward, amen, it's not the outer stuff. It's what's on the inside. It's what's on the inside. Hallelujah. Amen. And so, we cannot devour one another. Wait a minute. Yeah, don't jump on me because I missed 3 Sundays in a row. Come love me. Entreat me. Find out what's going on with me. Ella Noble. What the other day think he got to say? I ain't seen him. I've been here. Come on, y'all. Amen. See, that kind of stuff. That little leaven, that kind of stuff goes on. And would contaminate you. Amen. And contaminates the body of Christ. Oh, praise God. So we will destroy one another. Listen, there's a whole lot talking about the devil. Amen. And the evil spirits and all that kind of stuff. That stuff was conquered at the cross.
Yes, it was.
That's why when Jesus said, watch, we got to watch each other. Amen. And we've got to watch what we've been taught. And we've got to watch where we're walking.
Watch.
Amen. You got to watch you.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. And so verse 16, he says, so I say, let the Holy Spirit guide your life.
Yes.
Then you won't be doing what your sinful nature craves. Because your sinful nature, Sister Douglas, I tell you, you know, well, Pastor ain't been here, so I don't really want to listen to him today. That's your sinful nature. Come on, y'all. Amen. See, when you follow the Holy Spirit, when your life is guided by the Holy Spirit, then you won't do what your sinful nature wants to do.
Amen.
Your sinful nature, I tell you, today I don't feel good, so... y'all not gonna see me today, but I had an appointment to go shopping.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm feeling good or bad, I'm gone.
Don't call me.
Come on, y'all. You use a different standard when you want to do what you want to do. Compassion of what God is saying. Look at your life. Amen. Just look at that. What do you do for you?
When
you
sit.
You're going to call it God. You're going to try to get help. Amen. Praise God. Listen, you do things for you. What the Bible is saying. And that's what you're saying today. What's greater if you're led by the Spirit of God? The Spirit of God should move you. Should move you to walk in the Spirit and pray in the Spirit. And my prayer, I've been talking to the Lord, and I've been asking the Lord, Lord, make me a better intercessor. That's why, Lord, make me a better intercessor. Why? Because I see so much mess, and so many people that's messed up. I don't want to talk about you. I need to take you before you. Because he knows what's going on in you. I don't. I only observe you outwardly. Come on, y'all. Hey, but I know when you're acting like you're acting, something wrong with you. Come on, y'all. Something wrong with you. So I need to go before the Father. Amen. And I'm not going to tie myself down with you. See, that would be fleshly to start talking about you. Ella Steve, I don't know what's going on with Ella. No. That's fleshly. No, I need to talk to the Father. Because only the Father can get to his heart. Amen. Talking you won't help. It's just going to make me more frustrated. Come on, y'all. And that's what we've got to learn to. We've got to learn to talk to the Father. Hallelujah. What's happening with my brother? What's happening with my sister? And be an intercessor.
Amen.
And let God intervene where only God can do. Because they got a heart problem.
Yes, sir.
Sister Davis can tell you this. Amen. Sister Davis tell me about the offering and who's giving and who ain't giving and stuff like that. I said, honey, she'll tell you, don't worry about it. I said, they got a heart problem. I cannot address the heart problem. Only thing I can do is give you truth. The truth should address your heart problem. If you receive it. But if you don't receive it, you won't address your heart problem. Now I can address you outwardly.
Yes, sir.
Come on, y'all. Amen. But that ain't solving the problem. I like to get the problem solved.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. So I want the root. So I don't want to just deal with you because you didn't give this week.
Yes, yes, yes.
Come on, y'all. Because next week you'll give the sad family. But what down the road you gonna stop giving again?
Yes, sir.
But if I get your heart problem, amen, you're going to give continuously.
Yes, Lord. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good, y'all. God is good. Hallelujah. God is good. Let me move on. I got to get this stop sign. Praise God. Amen. Get this stop sign. Verse number 17. The sinful nature wants to do evil, which is just the opposite of what the Spirit wants. And the Spirit gives us the desires that are the opposite of what the sinful nature desires. These two forces are constantly fighting each other, so you're not free to carry out your good intentions. So what the Bible is telling us, that within you, you've got the sinful nature and you've got the Spirit nature. Come on, y'all. Amen. And you've got to learn through renewing your mind that you follow the Spirit nature and not the sinful nature. Come on, y'all. Amen. But it's by renewing your mind. And how often do you renew your mind? All the time.
All the time.
Every day. Oh, praise God. And the reason why people don't change, y'all, because they're not renewing their mind. And they get stuck in a place. Hallelujah. They're stuck. Amen. And they don't move because they're not yielding to the Spirit. See, the Spirit don't want you to be your old nasty self. The Spirit wants you to be gentle, kind, and sweet. Come on, y'all. Amen. And so the Spirit will move in you to move that way. But when you continually, amen, want to criticize and find fault and disagree, understand, that's the old nature. But that's not the Spirit.
Jesus.
Come on, y'all. Amen. And you got, as a believer, this thing. Once you're saved, there's a process called sanctification that you need to allow to happen in your life.
Yes.
And this process, what it does, it reminds you of how much God has did for you. And that you need to put in your life and start to practice it like he did. That's why he becomes our perfect example. And you can follow him. And when you follow him, you'll learn how to kill your old self, sinful nature. And you'll learn that it's not all of it, always about you and your feelings. Come on, y'all. You'll learn how to die to you so that others can live. Amen. Praise God. Because for love to flow out of you, love has to be grown in you. Come on, y'all. Amen. And so if you're not having love grown in you, love can't flow out of you.
Come on,
Pastor. Come on, y'all. Amen. And so the issue with the people, y'all, is what's ruling them is their old sinful nature, amen, and not the Spirit of God.
Yes. Yes.
Because when the Spirit of God leads you, you'll be led by love.
Yes.
Amen. Out of love comes kindness, respect.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. All of that, that comes out of love.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. But when you want your way, hallelujah, and you don't get your way, you have an issue with it. I already can tell you are not walking in Spirit. And you're not walking in love.
My God.
Come on, y'all. Amen. You're not doing it. So the Bible teaches me, praise God, amen, that I've got to die to me.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
My God.
I got to die to me.
My
and
God.
I need to promote my brother over me.
Yes, God.
Even at my expense.
All
right. Do y'all hear that?
Yes,
hallelujah. Amen. I've got to promote them at my expense. Not there, at mine.
My God. My God. My God.
That's the upper call. That's love.
My God.
Y'all want to love. That's love. Verse 18. But when you are directed by the Spirit, you're not an obligation of the law of Moses. Mm-mm. You're not under no obligation. When you follow, verse 19, the desires of sinful nature, the results are very clear. Very clear.
Very, very.
And he names it. Sexual immorality, impurity, lust of pleasures, idolatry, sorcery, hostility, quarrel, jealousy, outbursts of anger, selfish ambition, dissension, division, envy, drunkenness, wild parties, other sins like these. It's delicious and complete, but it gives you enough to know if you're in that environment, amen, then the old sinful nature is ruling your life. And you're not walking in freedom. He said, and let me tell you again, as I have told you before, that anyone living that soft life will not inherit the kingdom of God.
My God.
So people want you to believe that they're all right with God.
Oh, my God.
But you need to give them truth and let them know, Jesus, come. You lost. Hello, you lost. See, people got this warped idea of what it means to go with Jesus. If he will come back. And everybody said, well, we'll meet them in heaven. I want to say hell no, but y'all. Because, you know. You're going to meet them someplace. You'll meet them but someplace else.
My God.
Yeah, because you ain't right. Please, y'all, accept the truth. Don't live by stuff because it makes you feel good. And it satisfies you that, Pastor said, I ain't gonna tell you okay.
That's right.
I'm gonna give you the truth. Praise God. And then you got the word of truth in your life. Praise God. Amen. And so Paul says in verse 22, he said, but the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our life.
Glory.
When you got the Holy Spirit, what kind of fruit? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Your word, Eleanor. There is no law against thee. When you walk in freedom, y'all. Amen. No law against thee, son. Because all of those is embodiments of what Jesus is. Praise God. Amen. And when you love Jesus, when you got Jesus, I don't have a problem being gentle. Oh, come on, y'all. Don't have a problem being kind. See, my question is, who has got to you and given you some leaven that's got you so bitter?
Come on, Pastor!
Yes.
Who's got to you to make you so nasty?
Yeah.
And still you want to tell me about you having the Spirit. But right here in the Bible, I know you don't. I'm not your judge, but I am a fruit inspector. And what I see, y'all, don't line up with Scripture. And when I see lights don't line up with Scripture, I know. I'm like the little parakeet. Y'all remember the story of the little parakeet in the story. Y'all remember the story? The man going to the store, right? And the parakeet. Tell the man about
his wife, that
she fat, she ugly, all these kind of stuff. And so the man go and get the honor and says, your bird is talking. That's about my wife. And the honor come over and slap the bird around. Then you be nice. Bird was nice. The man's getting one, ready to walk out the store. The parakeet had one word. You know. He didn't say nothing. You know. Hallelujah. Amen. So there are things that we know. And then the next verse it says, those who belong to Christ.
Yes.
Belong to Christ. Have nailed the passions and the desires of their sinful nature to his cross and crucified them there. So my hate is at the cross. My dislike at the cross. Come on, y'all. There's a lot of stuff, y'all. Amen. I nailed to the cross. I thought I had things at the cross. But I found out in this season there's some things I didn't have them at the cross. I still have them.
Come on, Pastor.
I ain't going to let them go.
Come on.
Why? Because you hurt me.
Come on.
Oh, come on. And so I want to hold on to the hurt.
Oh, my God.
Because in the sinful nature, I want to get evil. Come on, y'all. Amen. I'm glad Jesus. Jesus didn't come. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. Because that step, y'all, would took me to hell. Amen. Not to heaven. Amen. And so I thank God for letting me know. Let it go. Release it. See, y'all, you can talk this stuff, but until you embody it in your life. There's a lot of people who do a lot of talking, y'all. The Bible says in verse, since we are living by the Spirit, let us follow. The Spirit leading. Where? In every part of our life. Not just to come here, amen, for you to shout hallelujah, to run around to speak in tongues. No! When they're nasty to you on your job, be led by the Spirit. When somebody cuts you off driving, be led by the Spirit. Come on, y'all. When somebody has dealt with you wrongly, be led by the Spirit. In every part of your life. Amen. Every part of your life. When your kids start right, be led by the Spirit. You say, but they did this, and I Sister Sandy right there, she's seeing. I got it right. Be led by the Spirit.
Yes.
I don't care who witnessed what. Come on, y'all. Amen. Greater than your witness is to be led by the Spirit. But y'all was there. Y'all seen what Carrie Ann did. Be led by the Spirit. See, God is, there's an upper call. And there's greater than what you did to me. Spirit. Come on, y'all. Be led by the Spirit. Amen. See, most times people want you to cave into your flesh. I would get it. No, they wouldn't get away with this. That's flesh. That's flesh. Hopefully, in this season, you'll learn to let go of some of the simple things you got in your life. And be led by the Spirit of God. Jesus. Nobody ain't gonna pat you on the back, and most times they don't gonna feel good. Come on, y'all. But you got to know what you're doing is right.
Yes.
Not how it feels.
No.
You got to know it's right. Praise God. And then the Bible says, let us not become conceived. I provoke one another. I'll be jealous. Of one another. Let's not be conceited. Let's not provoke one another. And when you say broke, it's talked about in a negative way, because another scripture tells us that we should provoke none of what? Another. But for good works, but not for evil stuff. Praise God. Amen. I believe God has an upward call for us.
Yes.
Amen. And each one, we've got to clean our lives up.
Yes.
Amen. We got to clean up. I share with some the word that I brought to y'all weeks ago about the clutter, decluttering your soul.
Yes.
That was a word to me. I'm glad y'all was able to receive it. I got it. Because what God showed me of how much clutter. How much clutter I was carrying.
Jesus.
New season.
New
I don't carry clutter. Because see, clutter, y'all, attached to my old nature.
Come on,
y'all. Hallelujah. And then these words, provoking one another, jealous. Oh, yeah, all those words is in clutter. Conceited, that's in clutter. Hallelujah. But there's an upward call of God. Why? This upward call of God, praise God, has to do with Jesus is coming.
Come on,
y'all. And I'm here to tell you, as y'all continue to look at what's going on, I don't know whether you're conscious of the fact that Jesus is coming. Just like he said he would. Praise God. Jesus is coming. Amen. I'm telling you, Jesus is coming. Who is coming? I don't know, but I know he's coming. Praise God. He's coming. And you need to be, and one of the things that I want to encourage you, you need to be prepared.
Yes,
and a lot of people aren't prepared. A lot of people have got, you're not prepared. I'm telling you, I'm warning you, you're not prepared. You need to get prepared. You really do. Amen. I don't know when you got, but you need to get prepared. Nothing is guaranteed. Praise God. Amen. I like Andre Crouch sung the song about, Lord, take me back to the place where I first received you. Take me back to the place where I first believed. And then he went on, he said, I must confess. I've been blessed. And y'all got to confess. You've been blessed. And I've been blessed. But I agree with you that said that. But still, my soul like satisfied. My soul like satisfied. Oh yeah, I got stuff. Yeah, and since things I got, I looked at it, we got a few dollars in the bank. I never looked at that before. My God. And then I looked at we got a few dollars in the bank. And this where my man, I was surprised. I'll be honest with you. Amen. We had a few dollars in the bank. But that don't satisfy.
Oh, come on.
That don't come on. That don't satisfy. My soul is not satisfied. And so Andre Crouch once said, he said, so renew my strength. Renew my faith. And restore. Restore, renew, restore. And when he said, to the place where I first received it, basically what he was saying, when I got you, Lord, I had you in a different way than
yes,
I got
yes,
you.
Yes, yes.
He said, I want what I had, but at the level of where I'm at.
Yes.
I don't want that element, but my mindset, my life was such small when I received you, and I gave you everything. And it was all or nothing. Nothing I would withhold nothing from you. So to renew and restore me, Lord, let me be here now. I don't want to withhold nothing from you. Listen, when at that point, y'all, whatever somebody said, I didn't argue when you said, you told me I had to come to church, amen, every night, I was there. I didn't think about the theological of the physical implications of it. Oh, come on, somebody. But now, yeah, when I say, let's come to church, well, I got something else going. Come on, because you got other priorities that outweigh, amen, your priority in Jesus. That's why it's an upper call. Amen. Our priorities, y'all, is screwed up. Jesus is my problem. But don't get sick. Don't have a problem. Pastor, can you pray for me? Pray for my kids. Pray for my mama. Pray for my dad. Pray for my aunt, my uncle. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. Amen. God is looking for a consistent walk and lifestyle out of you. He's looking for a marathon and not a sprint. It's an upper call. It's an upper call. Amen. So I encourage you, look at you. Check you out. Amen. Make sure, the Bible said, make sure you are in the faith. Make sure you're in the faith. Make sure you're in the faith. Hallelujah. And that's my constant pursuit. Amen. Instructions to make sure I'm saved. Come on, Jesus can come back in a moment. Between one breath and the next breath. He can come back. The loss of my son shows that. The loss of Sister Michelle Thompson shows that. I'm encouraging y'all that the next thing God promised you, you need to be prepared. Be prepared. And when I say be prepared not only spiritual, but be prepared physical and financial. Come on, y'all. You need to get your affairs in order.
Yes.
Amen. Get your affairs in order.
Amen.
Amen. I'm just telling y'all, get your affairs in order. Amen. Me and Sister Davis and Jesse Davis was talking about Betty White. Look at all of her becoming 100. She ain't making it. Get your affairs in order. It's an upward call, y'all. I'm asking you, and you need to look at things differently.
Yes.
Praise God. When you're looking at things like everybody else, you're missing what God is saying.
Yes.
In your family, in your workplace, every place around. The scripture says, all things work together for our good. Well, we're going to move into communion on this morning. Hey, praise God. I thank God. I'm going to serve you. Hallelujah. Got gifts that you failed to give when you came in. Please bring them now. Hallelujah. Amen. And I want to serve you today. Amen. Because the thing that God has really brought on my heart, and that's one of being a servant. You know? When you love, you serve. Come on, y'all. You will serve. Praise God. You will serve. And to serve. Hallelujah. Amen. And I thank God. I want to serve. I want to do what God has called us to do. I want to be what God has called us to be. Praise God. Amen. Let's love one another.
My God.
Amen. Let's love one. Now the Bible said, listen, y'all, don't love in word.
Yes.
But love in deed. Amen. Love indeed. If you love, love. Praise God. Don't tell me about love.
Oh, come on,
y'all. You, love is not love until it's in action.